There are a number of reasons why the water in a solar geyser can overheat. One reason could be that the settings are not optimized to match the usage pattern of the household, but that is a whole video in its own. In my case, around 2017-18, the Western Cape was struck by a severe drought and we had to seriously reduce our water consumption. This, together with my daughters leaving home for university, resulted that in the hot summer months our solar water geyser started overheating. This was simply because the sun was producing more hot water than what we were consuming, driving the geyser temperature to near boiling point. I started experimenting with shadow net to reduce the solar radiation received by the vacuum tubes, effectively reducing the sun's heat during the height of summer. This worked amazingly well. I found that 40% shade net worked best in my case. Since it comes 3 meter wide, I bought 2 meter length and doubled up the access, meaning the effective shadow percentage is probably around 50 to 55%. This results that the geyser temperature ends up around 60 to 65 degrees Celsius on a hot day, which is ideal. Without the net, on an equivalent day, the geyser would have ended up around 85 degrees plus. It was interesting to see some responses when I posted pictures of my idea on Facebook. A number of people said that I must switch off the mains. Another said that I must install a geyser wise to control the geyser element. A plumber's solution was to come and install a control box and a timer for me. Clearly none of these people had any idea how energy works. When a geyser gets too hot, the element never switches on anyway. All the energy in the system is thus from the sun. The only way to prevent the overheating is to reduce the sun's heat, hence the shade net. Shadow net is ideal for withstanding wind. It is strong but is also not a solid barrier. To increase its wind survival, I sandwiched the ends of the net between two strips of wood. The net was first stapled to the one before screwing them together. Using a hot soldering iron, holes were then made in the net at strategic points, which helped to prevent the net from sliding down the solar geyser frame. Cable ties, 5 on every side, works very effectively to strap the net to the frame. I keep an eye on the geyser temperature, and when it starts to exceed 70 degrees at the end of a sunny day, I install the net and keep it in place during summer, until it drops below 55 degrees again. If you leave the net on for too long, the system uses electricity unnecessarily to maintain the geyser temperature. My geyser wise is set to 55 degrees Celsius. I also made a second system using 85% shadow net for when we go away on holiday. With nobody home and no hot water being drawn, the geyser quickly overheats, even when the geyser wise is switched to vacation mode. This was made the same way as the 40% shade net system and simply installed over it if it's already in place. Installed by itself and with the geyser element switched off, that is the geyser wise in vacation mode, it was found to keep the geyser to 53 degrees after a week-long hot spell in midsummer. It gets removed immediately after returning from holiday by simply cutting the cable ties. You may have noticed the white streaks on my solar panel, which are bird droppings. Pigeons and hadidas are the worst. I got so fed up of them messing up the vacuum tubes, so I installed these makeshift anti-bird spikes. The proper PVC or polycarbonate or even wire anti-bird spikes are actually more expensive than galvanized sheet steel burglar spikes. In fact, the PVC ones don't last in the sun and are also known sometimes not to work. Since I never saw any big birds sitting on my perimeter fence fitted with these, I assumed they will work. And so far does, judging by the alternative spot my regular afternoon visitor now moved to.